all. It is Free Enterprise Friday, of course, and I'm here again doing live streams simply because it's easier, it uploads faster, I can get the information to you faster. So no worries if you didn't get an invite because I didn't send one out. If you are seeing this on YouTube, I am live right now. It is 8:22 in the morning Central Standard Time here in Texas. So if you want to chat or ask a question, whatever, go on over to my Google Plus. You can get there by clicking on the G Plus on my channel page, and that'll get you over here. I'm not going to be answering questions live again on this show, but I will answer them either directly to you or in next week's show. So let me go ahead and get into today's program, what we're going to talk about. If you tuned in last week, you heard that I'm going to be talking about social media today and how to do it the right way. There's a lot of people out there not doing it the right way, and I want to kind of demonstrate that to you because, again, whether you are, you know, a PTA mom wanting to build, you know, energy for your volunteers and your PTA, or whether you're the CEO of a company and you don't really know what you need to do with social media to get employees excited and customers or clients excited. Hopefully this will give you some good information. I think just basically I'm just going to jump right in. So again, if you have any questions or whatever, let me know. The reason why I'm not going to be going back over to YouTube to see if there's questions is that I have open right now 12 or 13 tabs for today's information that I want to share, and I'm afraid my little tiny baby computer will just crash away if I try to do anything more, so we're going to be lucky to get this done right here. So again, if you have questions or whatever, just leave it in the comments below on the YouTube video side, or you can try to come over to Google Plus and chat with me if I can get the chat to open at the same time. It may not work, though. Y'all know how that goes with me. But okay, just to begin with, social media as a basic, in a nutshell, what it is. What is it? Social media. It's a party online. Okay, just think of it that way. It's a party online. It's a virtual party. It's a way to interact with friends, family, and strangers, and friends of friends, things like that, in a very relaxed manner. There are trolls out there that are mean and horrible, but there are trolls that are mean and horrible in real life, so you just have to deal with them. So just ignore those people. We're not going to talk about trolls and address them, but just to let you know, if you're not on social media very much, then that's, you know, that's what you're going to encounter. But social media, again, you have to think of it like a party, okay? So from the mindset of a party, have you ever gone to a party and maybe you didn't know many people there, maybe you knew everybody except a couple people, and you run into that guy, you know, that guy, the one that all he wants to do is talk about his business or his product or his, you know, I don't know. You get what I'm saying, though. It's all about them all the time. Me, 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 me. That's another point of it. Maybe they're not trying to push their product to you or their service, but they are just monopolizing the conversation. It's all about them all the time. They're talking about them and how great they are and all this kind of stuff. So that's how to do social media the wrong way. Again, with it being a party online, that's how to do it wrong, is to be all about you all the time. Now, I know places like Facebook, for example, have turned into a very much kind of a photo book online. Everybody posts all their photos and all that, and you can do that. I'm not saying don't do that, but I am saying, because people do want to get to know you, okay? So it's a balance, and that's what we're going to talk about today, of how to do social media right. It is a balance between your personal information and your business information, whether it's you're an entrepreneur and you have your own business that you're selling a product or service, or whether you're a realtor, which is still kind of your own business, or whether you're, you know, a doctor or a lawyer, or, you know, you work at the local grocery store or whatever, and you want people, you know, to come in to what that is. So you have to keep in mind that it is a balance. But in today's world and in today's marketplace, at least in, you know, the majority of the world, not even just America, but the majority of the world where social media is easily accessible, there is no more wall between who I am as a person and who I am as a, you know, professional. There is no wall anymore. So always be aware of what you're posting online, and that is there forever. I know myself, I have, especially in this last election, probably got a little bit guilty of posting too many things. I'm Ron Paul supporter, so, you know, I posted probably too many things, but people know me, and they know that that's part of who I am, so I don't hide it, but I may have posted too many, and I'm going to give you all kind of some pointers here of how many is too many and things like that. So what I want to do now is I'm going to go ahead and go through the information I want to share with y'all, and then I'll come back, and you'll get to see my face here in a little bit. So let me try to get my screen share working again, if it will. Okay, I think that's right. All right, you should be seeing Twitter now. I've already logged in to my Twitter account. And so this is just when I logged in. Now, you'll notice right here I have 132 new tweets. So let's just go ahead and click that. And my apologies to any of these folks who I follow right now. If you're seeing your name here and if I say something bad about you that you don't like, feel free to unfollow me. And my apologies in advance. So I'm going to go ahead and hit that. And today is Friday, so you'll notice it's not here yet, but there's usually a Follow Friday that comes up over here. TGIF is something that comes up a lot. Now, these over here, if you don't know, these are called hashtags. Okay, you'll notice them here. Like, here's one right here, hashtag. Oh, good, I'm so glad he came up. We're going to talk about this man later, right here. Okay, we're going to talk about this guy right here a little bit later on today. This is a fun one. Happy Friday, people. Got any good plans? TGIF. I have no idea if this guy is selling stuff or not, but that's what I like to see here on social media. Now, I understand Viking Services is probably a business. I get that. But you see right here, one right after the other, Auto Grid Systems announces immediate worldwide availability of its demand response optimization and management. What the heck does that mean? Okay, that's too far above who you're you know, your theater is that you're talking to, all right? So Viking Services, you need to make this more user-friendly and not quite so general. Same here. Duke Energy Renewals acquires one of the largest urban municipal solar projects in California. That one's a little bit better because you've got the word in here, California, solar projects, municipal, urban municipal. So those are all good things in here. Next week, I'm going to be talking about keywords. So as I go through, understand when I'm talking about hashtags, that's a type of keyword. When I point out these words like urban, municipal, solar projects in California, those are all keywords. So we want to keep that in mind, all right? Mr. Guy down here put in about Google Plus. He's going to be doing, let's see, with Michelle. Okay, so that's something that's going to be coming up. Let me see if I can find one that is an example. Well, and of course, here's a here's a person right here. This isn't too helpful that it's not in the American language for me, but that's okay. Let's see. Okay, right here. I heard about this story yesterday. Chinese zoo passes dog off as a lion. This is for real. This is for real. They really did. So what you can do is you can click on that link and find out. So that's interesting, right? That's interesting. Let's see here. I'm trying to find. I'm not seeing, of course, as I'm live here trying to show y'all stuff. There are people on Twitter. Okay, here's an example right here. Sorry, Reinhard. What does this mean? All this is this person's name. And that. What does that mean? You know, give me some information of what you're sharing there, all right? That's a problem. So that's doing it wrong. Let me look. Okay, right here, U.S. housing starts rise in July but missed forecasts. So they've got their key, hashtags and their link that you can go to. So that's another way of doing it right. Okay, so in general, I'm not really seeing, unfortunately, let me see if we've gotten more new tweets. You will see a lot of times people that are just, all they do is about them. And y'all know who I'm talking about. And of course, right now as we're looking, I'm not seeing, seeing too many of them. Yeah, I'm not seeing too many of them. So actually, these people who are some of my people that I follow, they're doing it all right pretty much. Okay, let's see. All right, yeah. Okay, not really seeing too many different ones. But anyway, there's that. Here's what the Twitter looks like. Twitter is one of the top you know, social media platforms ever. All right. So one of the things you'll want to make sure you do is try to put in a link there, whether it's to, in this case, a video, or whether it's a link to, I think, a Facebook's person, whether it's a link to maybe a blog post or something like that. You want to try to make sure you do that in there. Now, you don't always have to have that. I think sometimes it's refreshing not to have one of those. Let me see if I can find one that does not have that in there. Well, and of course, isn't this just the way? Okay, here's a couple right here. Neither one of these have a link in it, okay? When you put how-to style info online, remember that you want it to last over time, even though things online change all the time. This is really great. This is a perfect way of doing social media. So BPJS, you're doing it right. This is awesome. Where it's just general information, it's a good point. You know, anybody that's reading this, they're not going, well, is this person selling something? Are they trying to promote something? Same thing here, okay, with Doug Bench. Your brain overflows with original ideas, but it also loves to imitate with neurons that watch what others do and mimes that action. Who are you watching? So, again, this is another very good, just stating some information here, asking you a question. You know, these two doing it great, all right? These are doing it great because, again, you don't know. Are they trying to sell something? Are they just people online? Who are these people? And that's kind of the way you want to do it because it gets people to looking at you going, oh, well, that's interesting information. I want to follow that person. Okay? So enough about Twitter. I'm going to log out of my Twitter. And then I'm going to close my Twitter. Now we're going into Facebook, okay? Oh, my. Here is my Facebook page. All right. Now, first of all, since he's here and I'm thinking about it, right here, this dude, y'all need to follow this guy. He is absolutely outstanding. He's from the UK, and he is just a wonderful guy. He's a former teacher. He does online marketing. So his page is Get More Momentum. He's just a great guy. So there's my little plug, and I wouldn't have done that had he not popped up. But he's one example of a guy that does very little talking about himself, and he does quite a bit about talking about his product or service that he offers. However, it's not offensive because very infrequently do you see him mention something and then pitch, buy, okay? Because that's something you don't want to do. But again, that's a good point there, and you can see some photos and things like that. Now, one thing I would just suggest in general is that you do not post on your Facebook, I'm going on vacation in 3 days. I'm going on vacation in 2 days. I'm going on vacation in a day. Okay, you just don't want to do that because that's a problem. People are going to come rob you. All right, that's just a little aside. But you can see here different things. Some of it is just my friends. Some of it are people that I know from Facebook and YouTube, things like that. So there's Shay Carl and Tobuscus. So just different things and different people, but again, you get more space. Now, you can see how much more dynamic it is to include a picture and some links, how much more dynamic that is as I scroll down. Here she's just, you know, putting in a little sentence, and that's fine because she's just talking with her friends. But see, it's just, that's the thing about Facebook, is that you want to show people stuff and things like that, okay? So Facebook is another platform that you might would want to consider if you're not on there already. Now, one thing you can do, let me go all the way up here to the top. I have several more than this, but these are some pages that I have and some groups that I have signed up with. And this is my personal profile that I started out with. This one right here is the one that I steer all my YouTube people to. They can join either one, but the information I share is different on each one. The Once and Again Emporium is where I sell stuff that, I mean, where I share stuff that I sell and I talk about antiques and things like that. Powerhouse Marketplace is more business related. So you get the idea that you can have your stuff and then other things as well, okay, other pages as well. And for example, maybe I'll post something here and then I share it and it ends up on this page. Or I post something in this one, and then I share it, and it ends up on that page, okay? So that's, again, another way. I'm sure y'all have seen a lot of these things, and that's fine, but I want you to look at it from a different angle and realize, are you talking about when you're going on vacation in 2 or 3 days? People don't care about that. Are you talking about the person that ticked you off somewhere? People don't care about that. So I'm going to log out. Now I'm going to go to LinkedIn. This is the Facebook for grown-ups. this site here is, like I said, it's mainly older people. It's professionals. You will get a lot of spammy people as well. Let me just kind of show y'all here real quick in some of my messages, and you'll be able to see what I'm talking about. Okay, these aren't too bad, actually. Sometimes they get very, very, very spammy. But these, so far in my inbox at this time, are not spammy, which is a good thing. Okay, so just going back again to the main page. And again, it looks a lot like Facebook. You can see here people, you know, here's where I would share an update. This is what LinkedIn Today shared. Let me scroll down so we can see a little bit more. And see, here they have like job postings and things like that, okay? So again, this is a way that, depending on what your product or service is, it's another good way to post information in more of a professional manner, because people on LinkedIn are expecting you to have a more professional demeanor and more geared towards whatever your product or service is. So consider LinkedIn if you're not on there already. Any of these social media sites are going to take a little bit of time getting used to them, so give them a couple of days to get used to them, okay? But there's LinkedIn. Now it's going to be a big bad boy that's coming up on the marketplace, and this is Pinterest. This is mainly a site visited by women. As you can see here, this is the page that comes up, and it's just, as you can see, picture, 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 picture. And isn't this funny, because women generally are not visually oriented, but boy, they sure are on Pinterest, all right? Now, again, this person, you can tell by the way these are set up, this person probably sells vintage or refurbed or even new custom whatever surfboards, all right? And that's okay, because look at how appealing the photo is. And they're not saying bye, 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 bye. And these are fins that go on the bottom of them, you know. Just really interesting stuff. Here it shows how you can use it like a piece of art in your house. So that is a lot of what Pinterest is creating an interest, a Pinterest, ha-ha, if you will, on, you know, different things for ladies to take a look at. It inspires people to try crafting projects. It inspires people to try hairstyles and things like that. And a lot of times, let me find one. For example, let's find a food one, okay, because that's probably pretty good. So let's look over here at this food one. Now, I'm just going to click the picture, and we're going to see what happens. And there's a picture of the food again. And see, this was posted by this lady here in her recipes and food section. And so you just scroll down, and there should be, yeah, okay, now see what she's done here? Okay, there's her website. So she's posted the picture. Everybody goes, oh, yum, yum, I want that. That looks delicious. How do you make that? So they'll click the picture, then they'll look for it. Oh, okay, look here. Here's a web address. Let's go to that. And see, she made it clickable. And I'm not going to do tutorials on how to do this. It's all inside of these platforms, but I'm trying to show you what the power is of these different sites, okay? So here it is. Here's her blog, all right? So, of course, she's going to want you to subscribe to her blog. And she's got recipes and all that kind of stuff up here. Now, do you see e-cookbooks? I can almost guarantee you that's stuff that she has for sale. So she is doing it right, all right? Now, she doesn't say anything on that picture inside of Pinterest of buy the book, buy the book, buy the book. She doesn't say, go and find out how to make this, go and find out how to make this. All she does is post it, make it so yummy that someone wants to click on it, okay? So pictures inside of Pinterest are very critical. They are very important. She looks like she is probably a professional chef or food author. And so, obviously, her pictures are lovely, but, of course, there are some very goofball pictures as well here. Like, here's a pretty goofball picture, but, you know, it's just precious because this person is probably her husband and their dog just being silly, okay? But that is one way a lot of people will put on here, like if they favorite it or whatever, and then say someone has favorited this and it goes on sale. If you're the person that posted this, then you can contact that person and say, hey, that Wine Stopper parrot that you liked is on sale, just letting you know, okay? So that's one way that you powerfully use Pinterest, all right? Now, I'm kind of zooming through these, I know, and you're probably going, why isn't she giving more specific information? Well, the reason why is because you have to decide where you're going to be social media-wise, okay? It's your decision to figure out which site you want to be on. Why can't I log out? There we go. Okay, so getting out of Pinterest now, we're going to go to Tumblr. This site here is a lot like a combination of Twitter and Pinterest, if you will, because it is very photo-based, but you can put in text, of course, as well, not a problem. This is very popular with the young people, so if you have a product or service geared towards young people, I highly suggest you consider Tumblr. You can look all the way down the side here and see all the different topics that are available. Like, this is just Spotlight, so this is general information, and we'll click on one here in just a minute, but I just want to show you. Okay, look at all these. Keeps going. Okay, so let me just click on, let's just click on nature since it's here, and these are different categories that you can put your post into. Okay, like you got the botanic garden, we've got some butterflies, we got some bears, some tree porn. Okay, see, that caught my eye. It's tree porn. Beautiful images of trees, woods, forests, and occasional jungle. Okay, so that's funny. They're doing it right. Okay, even though the word porn may offend some people, they're doing it right. Nowadays, in the youth market, the word porn doesn't necessarily relate to sexual things. It can be anything really awesome, like there's gadget porn, there's, you know, gaming porn, there's all kind of stuff. So in other words, it's things that they really think is awesome and over the top, but unfortunately, we're using that word. But hey, you know, the English language changes all the time. Here's a silly dog that's very long. So you can see here just different information about different things, okay? So let me just click on something. Let's just click on urban greenery here and see what's going on. Now this is, I believe, one person. Let's see, yeah. So this is like their page, okay? This is kind of like their website or whatever inside of Tumblr, urban greenery, all right? So you can see all the stuff that they post. Ooh, that's a pretty picture. All the things that they post and how fun it is. And if people find it interesting, they're going to comment on it. They're going to share it or whatever, just like any other site. Okay. Now, I have actually posted. Let me see if I can get to my dashboard, and I'll just show y'all what I did. I have not used Tumblr. I haven't used Tumblr a lot lately. But you can see here, I have put pictures on here of stuff that I have for sale online. I've actually had people contact me about it. Now, I'm doing it wrong here. I'm just telling y'all right now, this is the wrong way to do it. And I'm showing y'all intentionally that this is the wrong way to do it, okay? In that, all that I'm doing is sharing my stuff, okay? However, if I was to go in here and talk about antiques and collecting and things like that, then, you know, that would have more relevance. However, you can see all these people who liked these photos, so they may be interested in buying. So I could very easily contact them back and say, hey, I see that you clicked so-and-so, blah, 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 are you interested, or whatever. Okay, you get it? So Tumblr, again, another site that you can check out. I think I'm logging out. Yep. All right, now, let's go to what if you're not here in the States, you know, and different sites gain different popularity in different parts of the country. So I just did a search of top social networking sites. All right. Now this, as you can see again, is a paid-for ad. Do not click those. Those are irrelevant information a lot of times. So right here, we're just going to click this first one, and we're going to get 15 of the most popular social networking sites. You can choose them. If you don't want to be on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Pinterest, and MySpace, and Google+, you don't have to be. If you want to carve out your real estate in another site, you can absolutely do that. And there is sometimes the benefit to not being in the big pond with everybody else. But anyway, moving on. You got Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Pinterest, MySpace, Google+, DeviantArt, LiveJournal, Tagged, Orkut, I think is how you say that. I could never figure out how to say that. Cafe Mom, Ning, Meetup, My Life, and Ask FM. Okay, it's going to give you here the estimated monthly unique visitors. the competition rank, the Quantcast rank, and the Alexa rank. We're going to talk about Alexa here in just a minute, all right? Very important, Alexa rank. So Ask FM is number 144 in the Alexa rank. My Life is 1670, but they're number 14 on this list, all right? So you can see here just different ranking numbers and what they mean. But for some reason, these are the 15 people picked, okay? Just to give y'all some information. Now, as y'all remember a little bit ago, I was talking about Guy, okay, this man right here. I think it's Kawasaki is his last name, how you say it, all right? Here, this guy does social media right, okay? He actually works at Motorola, all right? But he has 4 million people in his circles, and this is just on Google+, all right? This isn't talking about his Twitter and his Facebook and everything else. This is just on Google+. He's a big powerhouse on Google+, and that's why I wanted to show y'all his particular site. But again, he works at Motorola, right? So let's see about his posts, okay? This was at 8:02, real life Wally robot, I can't even talk, robot, and this is a video, okay? He didn't make that robot, he just thought it was cool. Yesterday at about noon, and he's talking about a hangout, okay, and where it's going to be, and it's specifically about his company. Here's another one, shared publicly yesterday at about 2:00. Okay, this is again about the hangout. He's got a double post on that. And then the real story of Piper Kerman of Orange is the New Black. Again, another information and about his company. Coming on down. And then Ichiro congratulates Griffey. Something about his company. Going on down. And you can see here, special interest story, even though it's about this child in Saigon wanting to play with his little phone, it's also personal interest, okay? This is interesting information, how much it's going to cost to raise a child born in 2012, okay? So again, not about his company, just general information. 10 ways to make serendipity less serendipitous. General information, but interesting. Grasshopper divert single cam. Okay, you see how he could just be posting like crazy about his own company stuff, but he doesn't. He doesn't do that. So again, this guy, if you want to study him and figure out what he's doing, you know, go on over here to Google+. All right. So let me get back up to the very top. Okay. Now, also, just to let you know, I think let me see if he's got. No, he doesn't. Have it in here. Okay, so I'm going to click out of this Google+, and then I'm going to take his website. Okay, now this is his personal website. All right, do you see anything about Motorola right here? Even though that's where he works? No. Why is that? Because this man is a published author since 1987. This is what he promotes on social media. Is his own personal work, books he's written, and it's all about, you know, marketing and different things like that. All right, so this guy's doing it right. He creates an interest in the social media platforms, and then more than likely people are going to come here and either buy a book, they're going to listen to him speak, or maybe want him to come speak, just different things like that. Okay, so you can see here how he had his real estate, his social media real estate that brings people here to talk about, you know, buying stuff. He didn't post 10 posts about each of these books on every social media site that we saw, okay? So that's something you need to consider as well. Now, I want to show y'all about Alexa. Now, you'll notice up here it's alexa.com. This is very relevant and very important, and you need to pay attention to it. Because this is how you're going to find out, you know, which social media site do you want to be on and why. Okay, so I'm already logged in here. Now, let me just start by saying, Alexa, you used to did not have to have an account, and all the information I'm going to show you used to could be available for free, just about all of it. They do have you actually have an account. Now, it does not cost money, okay? They will have premium content, of course, that if you want that, you will have to pay for it, I'm sure. But literally right now today is the first day I'm on Alexa with an account. So just to let y'all know, if I stumble a little bit, you know, this is something you need to be concerned about, or not concerned about. Anyway, the site is alexa.com, and you can see up here it says Alexa, the web information company, all right? So let's just, for grins, let's just type in, since the first site I took you to was Twitter, and you want to type in twitter.com, not just the word, okay, and click search. Now you can tell right here, it's number 11 in the Alexa rank. Traffic rank in the U.S. is at 11. Sites linking in, 6 million, okay? And that's something that you want to see, is a lot of sites linking in. So this obviously is the same as that, but we'll just go ahead and hit click details, or I mean get details up here at the top. And again, the global rank, and it shows you kind of traffic here. Now, why am I showing y'all this? This is a site where you are going to be very powerful to find comparisons to other sites. You can find demographics. You can find what part of the world frequents these sites. And based on your product or service, you can kind of find out who your competition is going to be. All right. Now, you can see here that these are keywords that were put into search engines. Remember, we're going to talk about keywords more next week. And we've already talked a little bit about hashtags and things like that. So here we go, keywords. This is what brought people to the Twitter site. Either the word Twitter, the word Facebook, the word YouTube, this word that I can't read, or Gmail, okay? And 4.5% of the visits to this site come from a search engine. So in other words, this site is so popular, most people just type it in and go, all right? But there is still 4% that do it via a search engine, okay? Now, this is interesting, too. What sites did people visit immediately before this one? Facebook was 12%, Google 7.5%, YouTube 4%, T.co 1.8%, and Instagram 1.7%. What sites link into Twitter? And, of course, this is logical. Amazon, LinkedIn, Google, VK, and Google FR, which I think is France. Okay, I'm not sure, so you can rip me up in the comments below. What is the historical trend of this site? Okay, you've got the traffic rank, the reach percent, page views per user, bounce percent, the time on the site. Now, this is always interesting. This is time on site in minutes, okay? Anywhere from 10 up to about, right almost at about 15, okay? So that shows you people don't spend hours and hours and hours on Twitter, okay? Now, what you can do, you remember back on this other page, the one before this one, we had where we, you know, input the information and got there, okay? And then it took us to this page, all right? Now, what's going to be fun for you to see, let me show you down here, okay? Now, first of all, let me back up. I forgot demographics, okay? So it's showing here that it's more females. There's some males, but the females outweigh. With regards to education, there is no one that does more or less than anybody else. With regards to where, it's at school, more than at home or at work, okay? So coming down, let me see if I can find the, where's my demographic? Whoopsie, sorry, skipped it. Ooh, I think they've taken that off. Let me hit, okay. Oh, see, subscribe to Alexa Pro to view all the demographics. Okay, this is what they used to show you the age of people, and so now they don't anymore. So let me just, well, I don't want to do the Alexa Pro, and I don't want you to have to worry about it. So, but you can still function in this realm, okay? Granted, if you're looking at this right here, and you're looking at female, which is a little more green, and graduate school is a little more green, and at school, you can tell that at least for the past few months, that's where the traffic for Twitter's been coming from, is a bunch of chicks, okay? Here's the different countries. that are the top visitors, and then coming on down. All right, but let me show y'all something, if you noticed it. Oops, not down low enough. Sorry, I know y'all didn't see sick. Okay, again, this is the site's historical traffic trends. Let's go ahead and go back for 6 months, all right, because that gives us a little bit better. You can see the traffic in April, May, and June kind of went down, and it's gone way back up again. All right, so if you're on, you know, Twitter wanting to market yourself, then you need to look at traffic trends and stuff like that, all right? So let me go ahead and click in here, Facebook. Whoops, if I can spell right, that would be helpful. Now watch. Do you see that? Here's Twitter down here. See the Twitter line? And here is Facebook. All right. Now, I want you to see this, time on site. Let's see what happens. Bam. People spend a lot more time, obviously, on Facebook than they do on Twitter. Now, isn't this funny? Look right here. See this peak? Do you notice that that coincides to summer when school is out? Do you notice this bump here, again, when school is out? Okay. Now, let's look at LinkedIn. All right, let's add LinkedIn on there. Okay. See, LinkedIn is down here below Twitter. And see how it, wah, 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 I mean, it's literally a perfect almost wave that stays down here underneath the Twitter line. No up, no down. That's grown-ups. Okay, that's adults, that's business people using that consistently on a regular basis every day. All right, let's look at Pinterest. Now we're going to add Pinterest. Bam, it came up. I don't know if you can see it, but do you see this line that intersects with the LinkedIn line? It's still underneath the Twitter line. It's still underneath the Facebook line, but again, level. Grown adult women. Okay? Now let's look at Tumblr. All right, compare. Now Tumblr is also surprisingly down here and stays pretty level. So even though Tumblr may be frequented by younger people, they consistently go on Tumblr on a regular basis, okay? So this is a comparison where you can compare different sites, obviously, okay? You can look at the search percent bounce, the page views, you know. So if you're comparing websites, this is the perfect way to do it. Alexa, rack any website. I could put a website in there right now, and it would track it, but that's for purposes of this, we don't need to do that, okay? But I am going to go up here, and just for grin, since we've already seen that comparison, let's look at Facebook and see about the demographics on that. Okay, so it's ranked number one, global rank, and number two in the U.S., all right? Time on site, 35 minutes, daily page views, 17, and bounce rate is about 17, okay? So again, it's just slightly more female than male. Straight across the board here, again, education-wise, just a little bit more that they've had graduate school and a little bit more that they do it at home than at school or work, all right? And again, the countries, the top countries, what keywords they looked at to get there, okay? And then this, you know, you can see just boop, 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 boop. I mean, it's just pretty much even. Okay, now let's go back up here and do, what was that, LinkedIn? LinkedIn.com. And I know this seems tedious, but this is all part of researching your business. Oh, my computer may crash. This is all about researching your business and finding out how you rank, how other people rank. Alexa has a lot of great information that you can find out. Now, you can, of course, if you want to get that, I think it's called a pro account. I don't have one. I've never had one. And like I said, you can get a lot of information without having to pay for it. And I think sometimes, honestly, and this is just my personal opinion, I think sometimes people get a little bit too nutty into research and they don't take action. So for small business people, you know, which is who my main group is that I talk to, you don't need to spend a lot of time getting into the nitty-gritty of information. So here you can see the global and the U.S. rank, time and bounce rate. And again, this is on LinkedIn. Again, generally a little bit more females than males. They generally have a lot more graduate school. And then look here, no college. Relative to the general internet population, people who did not go to college are underrepresented. Okay? So in other words, you wouldn't want to market something to guys with no college education browsing at home on the LinkedIn site. Okay? And generally, these people are looking at work. So remember, LinkedIn was at work, Twitter was at school, and Facebook was at home. Generally, women in all of them, and graduate school in this one, and then the others were pretty much even. So this is interesting because it shows that education really has little relevance on these big sites worldwide. Okay? So that was LinkedIn. Oops. Computer's getting jumpy. And let me go back and let's do Pinterest and then Tumblr because I want to see the big difference on those with regards to time on site and sex and things like that. So here's Pinterest. Global rank is 40. In the U.S. it's 13. And again, you can see the bounce rate and time on site, etc. Now look here. Very skewed for women. Very skewed for women that either have some college or college. Okay? Generally, they're at school. Relative to the general internet population, people browsing from school are overrepresented at this site. So what does that tell you? This is probably mainly females who are college age during class, not maybe during class, but you know, at school is where they're browsing. So it could be even on school computers. All right, so Pinterest would be a great site to market things to young women entering the marketplace, you know, on how to job interview or dress the part for the interview or if they're, you know, wedding, things like that. Okay, so there you go on that one. And then again, let me go back and we will do Tumblr. Okay. And again, it's going to show us the global rank of 25. It's up 7. U.S. rank of 17. And you can see here how the traffic is increasing. So Tumblr is an up-and-coming site. All right. They spend about 7 to 8 minutes. It's, again, female, no college or some college, or maybe they're in college and at home or school. So, again, teenagers, okay, preteens. All right, so there you go, okay? Now, hopefully that gave y'all some information there of the different, let me see if I can get screen share turned off. Am I back? Yes, I'm back. Okay, so hopefully that gave y'all some information of why I'm wanting to show that to you, and I know the front part was probably a little bit boring because it was just, oh, I know what Facebook and Twitter is. Of course we know what it is, but the point is are you using it right? Now, you don't have to create entirely new profiles. You don't have to create entirely new accounts, okay? If last week you were ranting about, you know, your conspiracy theory, UFO, people coming or whatever, which there's nothing wrong with that, but that's kind of on the periphery unless you're promoting some kind of, you know, product or service or website or blog that's 100% about UFOs and conspiracy theories, okay? You can enjoy that stuff and maybe one of those posts every week, you know, just kind of for interest or whatever, maybe you'll find friends that are interested in the same thing. Y'all can talk about that in another venue. But think about social media from a different platform. If you got on just for fun and for grins and to find friends from high school and stuff like that, that's fine. That's not a problem. And you've probably accomplished that by now. So the point is now is what do you want to do? How do you want to make it different? Let me use an example here real quick, okay? Let's say that you're in a direct marketing MLM party plan situation, okay? For some reason, that whole industry has a bad rap. That's a whole nother conversation. But let's just say that you're a distributor for a company, all right? And let's just say either you just got in or you've been in for a while and you're like, oh, I'm going to use social media. Everybody says use social media. The worst thing you could do right now is to go into every platform and say, lose weight. You're going to do really, really good on these products. You've got to get these products that taste great and they're wonderful. Contact me for details. And then the next post is, oh, this is so great. Look, this person has lost all this weight and they only spent this much money and they became a distributor, get a discount. So contact me. And the next thing is a picture of the logo of your company. This is the best company in the world. It's awesome. And then your next post. Oh, look at this person. They just won a car from this company because they've sold so much stuff. That's where I'm going to be next year. Join my team now. Okay. Fortunately or unfortunately, on all those different things I showed you, we didn't come across any of those today. I guarantee you at least once during the week I find some of those people within my program. You don't want to do that. That's doing social media the wrong way. Okay, so let's flip it around. You are a distributor for a reputable company, and you're excited about being a part of it, and you know the products work. Okay, well, it's fine to post about it, but don't be in your face. Let me give an example here. Let me think of something. Okay, let's say that you've gone on a vacation and you've got a vacation pic or two of your family, you know, that you want to post or whatever. And maybe you're in some shorts or in a swimsuit or something like that. Your comment may be something about, we had the best time, you know, at so-and-so on our vacation, blah, blah. We just got back. And I was so excited that I was able to fit into my swimsuit, or that I was able to look good in these shorts or whatever. And then you can just do a little comment like, man, those new products sure are working. And that's all that you post, okay? And then the next post may be something about, today's a great day, the sun is shining, have a wonderful time, okay? You post these different things, and then one post can be specifically about, do you remember that picture I posted a while back about that I was able to fit in my swimsuit? Well, these are the products that helped me get there. And don't put, contact me if you want to know. Of course people can contact you if they want to know. It's a waste of space, it's a waste of time, and it's too pitchy, and it's too gimmicky. Don't do it. I'm going to get some water, so hang on. But yeah, that's doing social media wrong. Even if you are a company, like remember on the Twitter we saw about that solar panel company. Okay, I don't know where they're based or anything. I'm just going to make this up based on that it was a solar panel company. Let's say they were in California, okay, and they are a solar panel company that sells and installs solar panels for residential use. Okay, I'm making this up. Even if that is the case, and even if that is what you have chosen to start an account with specifically your business or company name, that's okay. You can do that. But in using social media, you don't want to just promote, here's solar panel model A, size, this, blah, blah, blah. You know, call to schedule an appointment to get it installed. It costs $500 or whatever. You can't do that because people will not follow you, they will not subscribe to you, they will not friend you, they will not tumble with you. I don't know what it's called on Tumblr. You know, they won't connect with you in any way because they'll be going, well, that's irrelevant to me. But if they are in a certain part of California and maybe they're a small business, they need to find out about the local school district and what's going on. Hey, did you see the Wild Mustang football team won their first game. Yay, way to go. My boss and I just ate at this great new restaurant down the street on 123 Main Street that's in their neighborhood, okay? So that's the whole point, is the social aspect of social media. I heard a YouTuber say it the other day, and it was something to the effect of that these big companies are coming in, like, to YouTube now, and they're wanting to what was the words he used? It was something like they're wanting to provide the atmosphere of connecting with viewers. And the YouTuber was like, no, it's not provide an atmosphere, but you connect with them. You know, that's what the social media aspect is about. Again, regardless of the platform, you connect with people. You comment, you help people. You know, let's again say that you're that solar panel people, all right? And you see somebody post, whether you followed them or not, in your different searching, you found out that someone lives in that area where your solar panel company is, and they're like, hey, does anybody out there know a good mechanic? The solar panel people are not in the business of fixing cars. But if you know of Joe Blow mechanic down the street who does a good job, you can say, hey, I've heard Joe Blow mechanic is really good. You might give him a try. Offering a suggestion. When someone asks a question in social media, they are wanting replies back. They are wanting information back. So it's open to respond to that person. Okay? Now, Joe Blow mechanic, if they're on social media and they're smart and they see their name came up in something, then they can go, wow, that was sure nice of you to refer me to that person. And then maybe Joe Blow mechanic contacts that person on social media where they can see it. And Joe Blow mechanic says, hey, I see that the solar panel company referred me to you. If you want to come in, I can give you a look over your car for free to tell you what's, you know, if anything's wrong with it. That's what social media is all about, okay? It's not about making a sale on the first time. It's not about pushing your product or service at every opportune moment in someone's face all the time, infinitum, until people are sick of hearing about you. It's about how can you help other people? It is truly a community worldwide of what information do I have that I can help other people with? Because you yourself know, whether you have a business or not, whether you are selling two things online every 6 months and the rest of the time you're a stay-at-home mom, okay, you know that you have a skill set other than what your business product or service is that you're offering. Maybe you journal every day. Maybe you found a good skincare that, you know, got rid of your kids' acne that you made in your kitchen at home. Maybe you garden really well. Maybe you know a secret trick to get a stain out of something. Maybe you know, you found a really great oil for your car. I don't know, okay? But you have an expertise in something even that you don't make money from. So that's on social media, what you need to start looking at is contacting those people, answering questions, sharing information with people that is interesting, that's fun. You know, this is what I talked about in the last show for this was make stuff shareable, you know, not just with the links and stuff, but is it interesting? Because like on Guy Kawasaki's site that we saw, he had that little video in there about making Wally the robot, okay? Well, yes, it's tech-related, and yes, he's from Motorola, but he didn't make that Wally. He didn't pay the guy to buy the parts to make the Wally. He saw the video, and he thought, now that's just fun. I'm going to share that. That's what social media is about. So, again, my rule of thumb on social media, and this is on every single platform, is that you post 10 posts total per day. You know, if you that's what I try to do is 10 a day. 9 of them should be about just kind of anything. 1 of them can be a direct sell, a direct invite, a direct request, or whatever for someone to purchase. Okay. Now you don't want to put your price on there. You've got to make the post interesting. You can't just say, we have a sale on mittens today, 2 for $5. Come in now. Okay. You can't do that, but you could write, when was the last time you checked? You could say something like, boy, kids sure do grow fast. Do your kids' mittens last year still fit? bring them in, you know, and we'll give you a free pair. You know, buy one for $5, we'll give you a free pair or something like that. In other words, begin it with, wow, yeah, kids do grow fast. Catch them with something that's of interest and relevance and just kind of a general statement, and then put in that soft invite at the end. Now, in the postings of the 10 times, you can post in there, follow me on Facebook, or if you're on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, okay? But in 9 of the posts, you don't want follow me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, follow me on LinkedIn, go to my website, follow me on YouTube, follow me on Google+, okay? You don't want to do that. Invites to follow on another social media platform, I do those 1 of the 10. So you've got 10, you do 1 invite to have them visit a website, join you on another social media platform, do 1 of those, and then another one of the soft, you know, the sell type item. So to me, that's how to do social media right. Now, I'm sure there are always exceptions to the rule, and somebody might come in and go, well, everything I post is about buying to me, and I'm making billions of dollars. My whole thing is, okay, if that's true, then why aren't you super famous, and why doesn't everybody hear about you, number one? And number two, if that is the case, you're probably something like Amazon or Coca-Cola or JCPenney. You know, you're probably a platform that is so big and so huge that by the sheer numbers of it, people are going to buy. But how many people does that offend? How many does it chase off? You know, because that's one thing that bugs me, for example, on Facebook, is all this promoted posts and promoted ads, and it's stuff that I haven't liked the page. I don't care anything about it. It's irrelevant, but they're advertising it to me. But as on any platform, you know, Facebook used to didn't have ads. It does now. Twitter used to didn't have ads. I guarantee you they will someday soon. Tumblr does not have ads. They will at some point, okay? And it's like I've said before, every social media site comes and goes, i.e. MySpace. I was on MySpace years ago. Then it got creepy and scary. I left MySpace. I went to Facebook. Now MySpace is really big and really popular for artists, music artists, and they post their music there or whatever, and it's become a very good site for that. So good for them that they adapted, but it's irrelevant for me because I don't do music, I don't promote music, I don't in any way, you know, have anything to do with the music industry. So I still have my account up there, but it's inactive. You know, I don't do anything. So that's the reason why I wanted to show y'all the Alexa site, and go ahead and get a free account because you can find out all kinds of information. Do a search, you know, just put in there social media sites. There are literally hundreds to choose from. You may find like Reddit, okay? You may like Reddit better than any of these other sites, and or Digger, I can't remember what it's called. It doesn't matter. It depends on what is interesting in your industry, where the people are going to be going that are in your industry, okay? Now, again, Alexa, and this is a little side note, but I want to throw this in there of why I even showed y'all Alexa. It's not just about finding social media sites, okay? Let's say that you went in there and typed in Cabela's, which is a sporting goods, like hunting and fishing and, you know, sporting goods type store. You can type in Cabela's.com. You can see more than likely it's going to be dudes, but you can see what sites they go to before they go to Cabela's, how they got to Cabela's, where they go after Cabela's, what kind of education do they have, how long are they on the site. Because the whole thing is, let's say you have sporting goods, you know, hunting equipment that you promote, that you sell, okay? Well, you want to find out, how did they get to Cabela's? It may be a blog site somewhere. And if it's a blog site somewhere, even if it's like Cabela's blog site, you can share articles from that Cabela site on your blog and say, hey, I saw this over on so-and-so.com, wanted to share this with you, thought it was really great information. There's one of your social media posts for the day, okay? So use Alexa, and Alexa's not the only one. There's other sites, but Alexa's the one that I found most user-friendly. Use sites like Alexa to find out, okay, what is a competitor site? What is a site that is either a direct competitor or it's, like I mentioned, the Cabela's type illustration. It's something that's similar to what I would do. Find out how they got there, what keywords they found it, what, you know, ethnicity. Because you might be surprised, and I'm going to be really silly here, but let's say Cabela's website is more frequented by women from home that don't have a college education. you'd be going, what? And let's say that the peak time is from, you know, October to January. What does that mean? Well, if you analyze it, you can sit there and go, it's a bunch of women that go online to buy stuff for their husbands or their significant others during the gift-giving season. And then the rest of the year, you know, they don't get much traffic, and it's dudes. So in other words, the guys may be looking at the Cabela site, but they're not buying. Again, I'm making this up, but I'm trying to use it as an illustration of the power of using a site like Alexa to go and find out about social media sites and to find out, besides social media, to find out who might be in competition or something similar to what you have, to find out, again, where did they come from? What sites are popular for my, who am I marketing to? Who is going to want to buy this stuff? You know, so for example, again, let me use it in more my case, and I'm going to get some water again. Hold on. Okay. Let me just get personal here for a minute. I sell stuff online. Y'all know this. Okay, and you know it's previously owned stuff. Generally, it's not new. Y'all know this. This is not new information unless this is the first time you've watched this video. Then it is new information, but generally, it's not new information. Okay, and let's say I have, because I do, I have old baby dolls and old Barbie dolls from like the late 1960s, early 1970s. Okay, so I could go to Barbie.com on Alexa and see what the age range of people is that go to the website. Because again, if these people are going to the website and you have a website, they're going to go to your website. Okay? If I had a brick and mortar store only, going to the Alexa website to find other websites is irrelevant because those people don't buy from a store. They're going to buy online. So maybe I'd go to the, you know, the Barbie website and find out what time of day, or not what time of day, excuse me, where that they're searching, what time of year are they searching. And then I would look and see, well, how did they get to Barbie.com? You know, and then you'd look for that in Alexa. Now, to back that up even further, in my search engine, I could type in vintage Barbie. Those sites will come up. They will be the top sites for that keyword search of vintage Barbie. And again, we're going to talk about keywords next week. But I've typed in the keyword search vintage Barbie. It brought up a list of websites. I look at a couple of those websites and go, yeah, these are good looking websites. I can see where they're on the top of this, you know, search result. You get that website name. You plug it into Alexa.com. You go down, you look at the demographics, you look at the time on the site, you look at where they were before, where they went after, the keywords. Am I making my point? I hope so. Because, you know, marketing in general is a lot of information. And I feel like sometimes I overwhelm or inundate, but I feel like if people watch the whole thing to the end, they will get the information, because sometimes things just can't be a snippet of information in 2 minutes and you get the whole picture. There's more questions left open than not. Am I right? Okay, so if you're not already, I want you to also go to my blog talk radio program, show, whatever you want to call it. It's blogtalkradio.com/WesleyGW. You'll see me. Go ahead and subscribe to that so you'll hear about upcoming shows, because as of right now, every Tuesday I have a show that comes up. There's archive shows on there. You don't have to listen live. You can do just like on video where you watch it later. But I'm kind of doing the same information, not same information, but the information overlaps on Tuesday and on Friday. Okay, so next week on my Blog Talk Radio show on Tuesday, I'm going to have a program about keywords. And that kind of goes right in line of what we're talking about on Alexa, how to find sites, how that is relevant to what I'm trying to do of selling my product online or my service online, okay? And also next Friday, on next week's Free Stuff Friday, I'm going to talk about keywords again a little bit more. And also I'm going to try to intermingle these together. Arnita32 asked a question on my day 27 video of the 30 days selling online, which is in YouTube. Go watch it if you want to, and then see Arnita 32's question. She was wanting to know more specifically about how to sell on Amazon. I've had a lot of people ask questions about that. I'm not really quite sure what they're wanting to know, but if a lot of people are asking, then I need to answer some questions. So if you have questions about how to sell on Amazon, you can either leave it in the comments below or send me a direct message. Go to blogtalkradio.com/WesleyGW and subscribe to my channel so you get notified when those come up. And that's just audio. It's not video, so that's an audio portion. And then next Friday, again, we'll have some more free stuff. More free enterprise Friday stuff. So I think that is it for me for today. I say this every time, but I'm sure I've talked way too long, but I'm hoping that people get information. I like to make these shows a little bit longer on the free enterprise Friday because there is so much information to share and so many things you can do free on the internet. Please don't pay people to do things for you on the internet. If you are too lazy to do the research yourself, then you don't need to be in business for yourself. That's just how I look at it. And the whole thing about lazy is that if you don't know how to do it, then just go, hey, I don't know how to do this, and then learn, figure it out. Ask me questions. I'll help teach you. There are other people on the internet that will teach you as well. So I think that's it. Again, that's all for me. So I guess that's all. So y'all have a wonderful weekend. I will not see you tomorrow or Sunday unless you watch some of my videos. Then you'll see me, but I won't see you. And ask questions, leave comments. I have a whole lot of stuff that I like to share with people. So I think that's it. So y'all have a delicious, delightful, delirious day. And I will see you on Monday. Goodbye.